but
thank you.
Lisa Keat, and Corey Ball, both choreographed by the film scene from Alice Lewis, had direct influence on the era's leading romantic contributor, John Wolfe. Later, also embraced neo-romanticism. The fashion world took notice as this production was covered in depth in Vogue magazine. Cotillon's star-covered tulle costumes by French artist Christian Berard likely inspired Coco Chanel, specifically her 1930s evening dresses that took their cues from the ballerina's costume. Although an avowed modernist, Chanel created a plethora of romantic, balletic-style gowns throughout the 1930s. Meanwhile, in England, Friedrich Bastian's 1936 ballet, Apparitions, likewise reflected the rise of neo-romanticism. The costumes designed by Cecil Beaton and fabricated by Barbara Kaminska influenced British couturiers such as Charles James and, more importantly, dressmakers of the world. Elizabeth, the Queen Mother, was one of Barton's clients. His balletic gowns, photographed on tour by Cecil Beaton, evoked the pre-war elegance and glamour of ballet costumes. Britain also produced one of the most famous ballerinas in history, Margot Fonteyn. Anointed a dame commander of the British Empire and, later, prima ballerina consulenta by Queen Elizabeth, Fonteyn was beloved by her country, tireless in dancing throughout the bombing of the Washington in World War II. Later, she became an international star after her 1949 New York debut. While on that tour, she and the company's other leading ballerinas modeled the latest London fashion, simultaneously promoting British culture and design. Fonteyn understood that high fashion could burnish her allure and reputation. Although her dancing is a stellar example of the restrained British style, Fonteyn loved Parisian couture and became a devoted Christian Dior client soon after his debut in 1947. The exhibition presents several Dior objects from her enviable wardrobe, from severe but beautifully cut day suits and coats to Fonteyn remained a loyal Dior client until the couturier's death in 1957. Around the same time, as she approached the age of 40, Fonteyn began to contemplate retirement. The 1961 defection of Soviet star Rudolf Nureyev, however, redirected her career and led to their partnership, one of the greatest in ballet history. They soon became the rock stars of the dance world, and together donned the latest youthful looks. In Fonteyn's case, she turned to couture Yves Saint Laurent to provide her with an array of elegant day wear and flamboyant evening attire. Meanwhile, in America, ballet was on the rise. In 1948, the New York City Ballet was founded by Lincoln Kirstein and Russian emigre George Balanchine. Balanchine's prima ballerina, whom he wed in 1946, was Maria Tolchi. Of part Osage descent, she was one of five Native American women who rose to international prominence in the mid-century. Tolchi, the most celebrated of them, was the first American to dance with the Paris Opera Ballet and was reportedly the highest paid ballerina in the country. Tolchi was also an exquisitely fashionable woman who, like Fonteyn, wore Christian Dior haute couture. So too did another American ballerina, Eva Page. After dancing with the Ballet Russe and Anna Pavlova's company, Page settled in Chicago, formed a world-class school and company, and amassed an enviable couture wardrobe, thus living up to her own words, be adventurous, be chic. Not only did ballerinas embrace and influence fashion, so did Barbara Kaminska. Born in Ukraine, she is arguably the greatest ballet costumer of the 20th century, first collaborating with European artist designers such as Christopher Ballard and Cecil Beaton in the 1930s. She moved to America, where she went on to form a legendary collaboration with fellow Nesbitt choreographer George Balanchine. Before embarking on a full-time costume career at the her innovations, such as long, with different colored layers of tulle or silk netting, can be seen the gown by couturiers such as Charles James.
Yes,
specifically Alexander's.